Hey guys, what's going on? It's Colin here again. Today I'm back with another fan restoration. This is an LAU, or LAU, I'm going to say LAU, Ultra 20 box fan. And this is one hell of a box fan. yeah, it's a 20-inch box fan, but then there's another at least 4, 5, 6 inches off this other side. Normal box fans end here and just have like controls on the top, but no, they decided to put all these controls on the side, which I think is pretty cool. I've known about these things for a long time, and I never really thought I would ever see one, because they didn't seem to be the most common. I always thought they were pretty cool, but I never really thought I would own one until this one popped up, and it was for the right price. So, a while back I found a GE 5-blade, plastic, 5-wing plastic blade box fan on Letgo, of all places. The guy had it up for $15, and I kind of stared at it for a really long time, because I do like the look of those fans. There's something about them, I like them. I've never had great luck with GE box fans in the past, but I like the look of it, so I kind of pinned the tab on my computer. The problem was, it was in Lindenhurst, which is kind of decently far away from me, and I didn't think at the time I would ever convince my mom to let me go get that. Well, today I decided to just check and see if it was still available, and when I was looking at that listing, I noticed that it had been updated a couple days before, and now this thing was part of the same listing. So then I said, oh crap, now I have to go get it. So I messaged the guy, and I said, how much for both? Or is it 15 each, or 15 for both, or what's the deal? And he said, well, I was thinking 15 each, but if you want both, I'll cut you a deal. So, anyways, I ended up coming home today with two more box fans. That GE, which you guys may or may not have already seen a video on. If not, it's coming. And this one for $20. So that's $10 a pop, which, even if these are both junk, that's $20. So I'm willing to take the risk for $10 a pop. Plus, this fan is pretty freaking cool, so... Anyways, in this video I figured I'd just do one of my time-lapse restoration videos, which I'm not entirely sure how far I'm going to go with this one. I don't know whether I'm going to get into like repainting it or anything like that. I might do that in the GE one, but I'm not entirely sure yet. I'm kind of going to kind of just figure it out as we go. Anyways, I'm going to pop you guys off the tripod and we'll take a closer look. Alright, sorry for the background noise and the mess. I'm down in the shop here. And this place doesn't usually stay clean because my dad doesn't always have a lot of time to clean it up. So you end up with stuff like that. But anyways, that's besides the point. Just figured I'd give you guys a little closer up look at this thing before I go ahead and restore it. Handle's not broken. It's supposed to pop up and down like this, but originally there were like rubber pieces here, I think. So I might just get some pieces of rubber that hold it up like that all the time. But yeah, I love that Ultra 20. Look, I think this fan is probably dating back to the mid to late 50s. I don't think it's quite an early 60s model yet, but I could be wrong. It's actually a very low profile fan. It's really thin, but it's just super wide. So I guess it's a trade-off. So it's a 3-speed. It's got the safety eye, which is basically just a pilot light, which is pretty cool. I don't know what's safe about it, other, I guess, than to tell you it... Oh, you know what? Maybe it stays on when the thermostat is off, so it lets you know the fan's still got power. Speaking of the thermostat, there's the thermostat. And down here is the reverse control, because this thing... It's big enough and heavy enough that I could see why you'd put it in front of a window and not want to spin it around. This switch is actually frozen up right now, so that's another thing we'll have to take a look at. Paint's in okay shape, considering the age. Some of this might clean up. The grills are very dirty. And those I may or may not repaint, I'll have to see. I don't know if I'm gonna get into repainting the whole cabinet. I'm gonna just try and clean it up. This is like some sort of plastic material. Don't know what it is. The back grill's obviously got a little bit of an issue here. Doesn't really, oh, you know what, there we go. Oh, one of these clips is a little bent, I think. That's gotta come up a little more. Big old motor. I think it's a Fasco, if I'm not mistaken, but I'm really not sure. And I'm also not sure whether it's shaded pull or PSC, but I guess we'll find out. And you can see it's just kind of dirty and grimy, but it does work. I think this may be the original cord, and it's nice and long too, but go ahead and plug her up. It does run, it needs some help though. So if I can find the outlet back here, there we go. Let's start off on high. You can see the safety eye works. So it's got some vibrations, but it's also got some bearing noise. That doesn't sound super healthy. Hopefully that's more thrust washers than anything, but we'll see. Put it down to medium. Thermostat works. Oh yes, that does stay on, so that's probably what that's for. Yeah, that's some serious bearing noise. I think this back support is a little bent too, but we'll have to see. That could also be why the grill's not staying on right. It's got a Venturi ring too. I'm sure you guys all noticed that, but I didn't say it. I kind of just noticed that actually. Jeez, it was a bit of a busy day. We'll go down the low here. This thing's really quiet, but it is throwing out the air like you wouldn't believe. That's a really slow low. I don't know if it's supposed to go that slow or not. That seems awfully slow. I can't expect that that's how slow it's supposed to actually be. I don't know if reverse works because the thing is stuck, but the bearings seem pretty free, which actually makes me a little nervous. So hopefully that's more thrust washer noise than anything. Hopefully the bearings are still okay. But I guess we'll see. But anyways, guys, I'm going to throw you up on the tripod here. And this might be a bit of a longer one, because this is going to need a lot of work. But anyways, I think it's time for the time lapse. Alright, so it's that time of the video, folks. It's the time where I plug it in after oiling the motor and see if just oiling it did enough. I was surprised to find when I pulled this motor apart that A, it wasn't very dirty, and B, it looks like it had been recently oiled. So I guess maybe somebody had serviced this thing with the oil ports at some point, but let's see. I think it's still going to make that noise because I think it needs some thrust washers, but that's not too bad. Oh, I mean, that play is bad, but it won't be too bad to get thrust washers. Oh man, even without them, it's so much quieter. Wow. So, just oiling it made all the difference there. Cool. I think it's quiet. Man, does it throw a lot of air. Definitely needs thrust washers, though. I don't know if I'm doing that in this video, though. Remember when I said this piece was plastic before? I should have known better. That's metal. Also, I think somebody's been in here before and I think somebody replaced the cord, so this one probably isn't original. So I'll have to decide whether I want to keep that or not. Anyways, let's continue. Oh, I just broke it. I just broke my reverse switch. That sucks. I did something I never should have done. I knew I shouldn't have either. I pulled the switch apart. That's a big no-no. I don't know what I was thinking. But, yeah, I broke it. This little tab broke off of here. And that's not going to work anymore. So, that sucks. I'm going to have to think about what I want to do there. I mean, I can replace it with a toggle switch, but I was preferring not to do that, but I guess I don't have a whole ton of choices, do I? I can see if I can find a new rotary switch. That would be cool, actually. Just find a new rotary switch to put in there. But, yeah, I'm not super happy right now. But I did just test it, and reverse does work. So that's good. The other thing is that I didn't notice until now, or before, during the time lapse at least, this thing's actually got a speed coil in it, and that's how it determines the speeds. So I'm praying that that is good, because if that isn't good, then we're going to be stuck with a high speed only. Well, actually, no, that's not true, because it's got individual winding, so if one of the speeds go out, then, well, we're kind of screwed. I guess we'll just deal with it, but, yeah, so I guess that's it for tonight, for me at least. For you guys, it'll be about a split second before I get back, but I'm going to have to run down to the hardware store to grab some thrust washers anyways, because this thing, I know I mentioned it before, but definitely needs it, so while I'm there, I'll look around and see what they have for switches. But yeah, oops, oh well, what are you going to do? But I think that's it for tonight, so I'll see you guys back in a second. Alright guys, so it's the next day now. I just got back from the hardware store, and I got a new switch for the reverse. Fixed my stupid mistake, and I got some fiber washers. So, let's continue on. Thank you. Alright guys, she's done. Came out pretty darn good, I have to say. It cleaned up a lot more than I thought it would. What I thought was a lot of rust and dust and crust ended up just being like really, really thick dust. So once that washed off, it actually came out pretty darn good. Still a little annoyed that I broke the reverse switch, but honestly, the toggle doesn't look too terrible and it's definitely clunky enough to pass. I did end up putting the thrust washers in. That made a world of difference. The bearings in this thing are actually really good. Initially I thought they were really sloppy, but they're actually perfect and this thing runs great. There, knock on wood, doesn't seem to be any issues with the speed coil. Thermostat works fine, reverse works fine. The only thing I might do at some point is adjust this handle. It is supposed to be loose, I'm just not thrilled about the masking tape. But we'll figure it out. Grills still have some crap on them. At some point maybe I'll power wash them, but looking at it directly, you know, forward, it looks alright. If you look down on it, kind of like this, you can see how rusty they are. But I think I'm just going to leave this one the way it is and call it a patina. but anyways, go ahead and do the final test here. Actually, you know what? Let me turn off this cooling fan back here. I don't know how much of a difference that made with the computers I have going back here. I might have to do a video of this at one point. I have a whole folding at home rig. Anyways, let's start out on out so it doesn't give you guys a ton of wind noise and high speed. I'll get a startup sound in a second. This thing, as it should, moves a ridiculous amount of air for the amount of noise it makes. And it would be even quieter if I put a little like felt pad on the back of the motor so that the grill doesn't vibrate, because it does vibrate a little bit. Go down the medium. You can see the safety eye is working. If I turn it off here, that stays on. That's what that's for. It lets you know that the fan is still, you know, like turned on even if the thermostat kicks it off. I'll get back up to speed here. Go down to low. And surprisingly, unlike a lot of box fans from this era and just in general, this thing moves just about the same amount of air and makes just about the same amount of noise regardless of which direction you have it in. But I'm going to kick it back up to high and we'll do a spin down here. These bearings are actually in really good shape. And this thing has a nice low. It is super quiet, yet it will throw you across the room with all the wind it's moving. But the bearings are actually in really good shape, and the big metal blade helps. Might have to do a spin down contest between this and my freshened air. See which one works better. Interestingly, this has the same like smaller shaft as the freshened air. I've recently learned that they're both Fasco motors, so maybe that has to do with it, but it's interesting, like, if I want to, I can put a blade from, like, a modern Lasco on, which I may just have to do in a minute here. Alright, let's do intake. Prepare for wind noise. Gonna go through the three speeds, and we'll do a startup sound, so here's high. Nice strong breeze. It's great. That back grill vibrates a little bit. Check out this nice low it's got. Here's a tissue. See just how much air it's moving just from that. I think the patented Jordan U toilet paper tester works better, but this is what I have down here. It's got a nice powerful low. So let's get a startup sound and then maybe I'll do that blade swap just for fun. Alright, so I got the camera as close to the motor as I can, so let's start it up on high here.
got a very subtle, like, harmonic noise to it, but it's there. So I'm going to let this thing spin down, and we'll start it up on low.
All right, here we go on low. You got a little extra hum from the speed coil. I think that's all she's got. Alright guys, so I decided against doing the blade swap in this video because I pulled the grill off and I realized that this thing actually has a second little clip to keep the blade from sliding off the shaft if the set screw were to come loose, and honestly I'm too lazy to undo it right now. But I've also figured that I'll just do a separate video on blade swapping between this and the freshened air with different blades that I have, and I think that would be a little more interesting. So stay tuned for that video, but anyways guys, thank you all for watching. I hope you all enjoyed the video. If you did, feel free to hit the like button or subscribe. I would appreciate it. And by all means, leave a comment if you have one. So anyways, guys, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.